we're elected in 2015, we will stick to the Tories' spending plans. Why would you vote for them then? Why would you vote for them to implement the same cuts as these swine are already implementing? Brothers and sisters, no wonder. No wonder the English working class feels so disenfranchised, feels so disillusioned, because they don't have a political party to represent them. Ed Miliband, you wouldn't allow him to run a bath, never. We have got the chance to show concretely that we can do things differently. We can invest in health, we can invest in education, we can invest in social housing. We can show the English working class that they can reclaim their organisations and their traditions as well, because they're going to say, hey, if it's good enough for the jocks, it's good enough for us. This debate, brothers and sisters, this debate has nothing to do with political parties or politicians. This debate is about You know, and some of you might say, Tommy, you know, he's been doing a lot of these meetings, this is his 96th meeting, maybe he's been listening to that Braveheart scene. Maybe he's been wearing that kilt in the house, you know, and waving the kite off. I thought he was teetotal. Has he actually had a few sherbets before the next meeting? Brothers and sisters, this is about freedom. Yes, we might not be in shackles and chains, we might not be in prison. As I say, these meetings were not even in handcuffs. And I know a thing or two about being in handcuffs. I'm looking up the back here and I can see a few of the boys. I think they know a few of Brothers and sisters, just in case there's any gutter snake journalists in here tonight, none of it for kinky reasons, by the way. Has rejected the political creed of greed. This wee country, Scotland, has rejected the political agenda that dictates the way you motivate the working class is you pay them less and get them to work longer. But the way you motivate the ruling class is you cut their taxes and give them bigger bonuses. This wee country, Scotland, has rejected the political manifesto that states essential public services are for sale to the city spirits in London to make them even richer than they already are. Since 1951, Scotland has rejected all of those political ideas. Because since 1951, this country has refused to vote for a Tory government. That's the reality. Here's the political handcuffs. Since 1951, we've had to endure 35 years of Tory governments that we never voted for. That's the political handcuffs. Brothers and sisters, you want one good reason to go back into the house tonight and convince every one of your family to go into your Guatemala and convince every one of your workmates to go into the local cafe or the pub or whatever you socialise to convince everybody in Scotland to stand up and vote yes? Surely after experiencing the poison of Thatcher, the way she destroyed the industrial base of this country. She detested us because we refused to accept her idea that there was no such thing as society. We believe there is such a thing as society. It's looking after your neighbours. It's looking after your grandparents. It's looking after the disabled. It's looking after the kids. That's what society's all about.